everything you need to know about every thyroid disorder. Signs, symptoms, causes, treatments. Our hormones can be difficult to deal with at times, but it's because of them that our different bodily systems have the ability to talk to each other. With that said, you may or may not know the symptoms associated with thyroid disorders. They are the most dominant of the endocrine disorders. These types of disorders are the direct cause of the dysfunction of the hormone messengers, and hypothyroidism, which affects 4.6% of the U.S. population, and hyperthyroidism, which impacts 1.2%, are the most common, according to the National Institute of Diabetes and Digestive and Kidney Diseases. Before we begin this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more daily tips like this and turn on notifications so you never miss our new videos. What is hypothyroidism? According to the Mayo Clinic, this disorder means that your thyroid gland is barely active and there is not enough of the thyroid hormone in the blood. Hypothyroidism is also called underactive thyroid or low thyroid and is classified as a disorder of the endocrine system in a person's thyroid gland. It occurs when the thyroid gland does not produce enough thyroid hormone. This results in a number of different symptoms. The symptoms can vary from person to person, but one clear signal is the ability to lose weight. Women who are over the age of 60 are much more likely to develop hypothyroidism, which upsets the balance of chemical reactions in the person's body. There are rarely ever symptoms that show in the early stages of hypothyroidism, but over time, and if left untreated, hypothyroidism can cause an assortment of various different health issues. These issues include obesity, infertility, joint pain, and heart disease. There are, however, all sorts of accurate thyroid function tests which can diagnose hypothyroidism, and treatment is very safe and effective. With low thyroid hormone in the blood, many of the body's systems are slowed down, so another symptom according to the Mayo Clinic would be a lack of energy, sluggish, and becoming tired very easily. If your body doesn't have a working metabolism, which slows down with this disorder, the body temperature is affected and people become cold. A slow metabolism can also lead to constipation, which is another telltale symptom. Depending on the severity of the hypothyroidism, symptoms develop extremely slowly and usually over a number of years. Symptoms such as fatigue and weight gain are not noticeable at first, but a person's metabolism continues to slow down, more obvious symptoms of hyperthyroidism become noticeable. These symptoms include increased sensitivity to cold, constipation, dry skin, fatigue, muscle weakness, and more. You may also notice that you have thinning hair, a slowed heart rate, or even impaired memory. Untreated, hypothyroidism can result in symptoms which become more and more severe over time, leading to an enlarged thyroid, forgetfulness, or even depression. Advanced hypothyroidism is known as myxedema. Myxedema is very rare, but can actually be life-threatening. Symptoms include decreased breathing, decreased body temperature, low blood pressure, and unresponsiveness. In some very extreme cases, myxedema can actually even be fatal. Hypothyroidism can also occur in infants. Newborns with hypothyroidism may experience symptoms which include yellowing of the skin and in the whites of their eyes, known as jaundice. Jaundice occurs when a baby's liver is unable to metabolize the substance bilirubin, which forms when a person's body recycles damaged or old red blood cells. Other symptoms include a large tongue, a puffy face, and frequent choking. As hypothyroidism progresses, infants may have trouble feeding and may experience developmental issues. They may also experience constipation and excessive sleepiness. Untreated hypothyroidism in infants can also lead to intellectual and physical disabilities if left untreated. Hypothyroidism in children and teens may also cause delayed puberty, poor mental development, delayed development of permanent teeth, poor growth, and more. Interesting, right? Well, keep watching for some more information on hyperthyroidism, another common thyroid disorder which people all over the world suffer from today. Hyperthyroidism. This thyroid disorder is the total opposite of hypothyroidism. Hyperthyroidism means that there's too much thyroid hormone in the blood, says WebMD. Also different is how it affects the metabolism. Unlike hypothyroidism, this disorder speeds up the metabolism. Those who experience hyperthyroidism will feel very anxious, nervous, and irritated because their system is on hyperdrive, says WebMD. This may also cause people to have trouble sleeping and may also experience muscle weakness. There are many different treatment options available to those who have hyperthyroidism, such as antithyroid medication and radioactive iodine, which slows down the production of thyroid hormones. Some cases may require surgery to remove the thyroid gland. Symptoms of hyperthyroidism are similar to many other health problems, which can make it difficult for doctors to diagnose. These symptoms include sudden weight loss, rapid heartbeat, increased sensitivity to heat, difficulty sleeping, fatigue, muscle weakness, and more. Older adults may not show signs or symptoms. A common problem associated with hyperthyroidism is a disorder called Graves' ophthalmopathy, which makes a person's eyeballs protrude beyond their protective orbits. This happens because the tissues and the muscles behind a person's eyes swell. Other signs of Graves' ophthalmopathy include red or swollen eyes, light sensitivity, blurry or double vision, or excessive tearing or discomfort in one or both eyes. Cause of thyroid disorders. The most common cause of hyperthyroidism is Graves' disease, which is an autoimmune disorder and the most common cause of hyperthyroidism. It causes antibodies to stimulate a person's thyroid, making it secrete excessive amounts of hormone. Graves' disease is much more common among women than it is among men, and it's usually genetic. Other causes of hyperthyroidism are tumors in the ovaries, benign tumors of the thyroid or pituitary gland, excessive iodine, large amount of tetraiodothyronine which are taken through medication or supplements, and more. In some cases, these disorders are due to the body's immune system mistaking thyroid glands and their enzymes as attackers to the system. This type of hypothyroidism disease is called Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Hyperthyroidism can be caused by the development of nodules on the thyroid that will grow and increase the input of thyroid hormone, explains WebMD. How to detect and treat these disorders. If you or someone you know is developing symptoms that were mentioned above, doctors will conduct blood work to confirm if the thyroid hormones are in range. The Mayo Clinic explains that the treatment for thyroid disorders normally includes the prescription of a synthetic hormone called levothyroxine. Also, antithyroid drugs that block production of your own thyroid hormones may also be used. Certain key factors that play a big role include leaky gut, diet, toxins, infection, and stress. So if practitioners suspect the disorder may be autoimmune in nature, then food sensitivities, especially gluten, and digestion are looked at, according to Mayo Clinic. In order to function properly, the thyroid needs several key nutrients. So it is possible that addressing nutrient deficiencies, such as selenium and zinc, may be a factor in treatment. Other hormones, like cortisol and the sex hormone, should also be tested due to the integrated nature of the endocrine system, says Mayo Clinic. In order for healing to begin while being treated, it is essential to address the root causes that could be at play. A doctor can help evaluate your current condition and give you professional advice about your health in the event that you are diagnosed with a condition or disorder. Most symptoms associated with thyroid disorders are very slow and gradual. You may not notice the symptoms at first. This is why it is important to monitor your health. And the moment you start to notice symptoms like extreme fatigue, excessive weight gain or loss, dry skin, puffy eyes, and/or a pale face, consult your doctor to rule out any thyroid disorders. If you are diagnosed with a thyroid disorder, your doctor will put you on a course of treatment to minimize your symptoms. Of course, you should also make sure to maintain a healthy lifestyle, which includes exercise and a nutrient-rich diet. If you need help determining how to incorporate healthy foods and/or exercise into your new routine, consult with a professional to ensure you are doing it the right way. Particularly, if you are a senior or have certain medical conditions. Do you have any experiences with thyroid disorders? Tell us about it in the comment section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this, and thanks for watching!